धन्यवाद भाई साहब। Tanglangla was a bit tough because the route to Tanglangla, like the last 5 kilometers, the road is like a 6-lane highway, although it's like a 2-lane road. It looks like a 6-lane highway. It's simply a plain road. Your bike will feel overbeat. And after that you'll start seeing good places, good landscape, because you start entering the 120 kilometer belt towards Delhi. So after that you will reach Karu, and then you will go towards Leh from there. Karu is like 35-40 kilometers away from Leh. So that's how I reached Leh. A couple of experiences when I was crossing Rohtang. I have already said it, but I will say it again. Try to make sure you don't overstress your body when the day you're crossing Rohtang. Because the road after Rohtang is like, there is no road. There are big stones, big holes. The whole off-road route. If you're comfortable in doing that kind of route for like 200 kilometers, then it's all right. If you're not, do that road. Try heading out for Kilong or Jispa. Stay there and do Leh the next day. That way you'll be able to see the whole place. That's my experience. I met this guy from Kerala. So these are a couple of incidents. I met this guy from Kerala. He was traveling on. He was riding on his 220. I was riding on mine. So that was one connection. Second, he was solo. But he was not traveling all the way from Kerala. He shipped his bike to. I think he shipped his. So this guy shipped his bike to Chandigarh, and from there he was riding towards Leh, and the guy was riding quite well. He had some problems, so a couple of places on route I saw him, and you do the biker way like this. So you do this. And the guy in front will do this as well. There's no other connection. So we did biker wave and that sort of shit for two or three times, and then he met me at Nakila. And we sort of decided we are gonna try and ride together. That builds your morale on that route, because midway you will cross Pang and Sarchu. Some of the most roughest terrains you'll ever see. So happened. So we were going through this downhill slope, which ended up in a straight rough track, and on that straight rough track a stream was flowing downhill, and a Punjab number, I think it was standard, I guess it was standard or Machismo, the guys had some problem with the electricals of the bike. The owner of the bike, he admitted that he made some changes to the light. It's quite possible that's creating a problem, because the bike was not starting up. They tried changing, the bike was not starting up at all. It was not firing up, no power at all. They tried changing the fuse. They tried fiddling around with the headlight. The headlight he's put on. So at such terrain, there is no point in leaving someone stranded. So what I thought was staying with them. Till the time, because I generally know mechanical problems, a basic rider can solve them, but an electrical problem with the bike that I don't know much about, I would rather not fiddle around with it, because it might create another problem. So I chose not to do anything with it, but wait for someone to come in. A few moments later. Few moments later, this group from the riders were from Bangalore, but they rented their bikes at Manali. So they were riding J&K numbers. They came in, and we told them the whole problem. They were riding Bullets Classic. So I guess they knew about it, because the moment we told them about the problem, one of them just parked the bike and popped onto this bike, started fiddling around with the fuses and all of the other stuff. We told him, dude, wait, they have done all of that. I know that much because at that point I was relieved that these guys, they had some help around. So so this is the moment we I parted with the guy from Kerala. He had his regional company, I would say. So he started talking to them. I said, let's move. And I came to my bike, started riding. I see no traces of him. After that, I crossed a couple of places. After Pung, you get this place where there are a lot of coffee shops, just eateries around. People were chilling out there, waiting there to rest, to do their shit. And I was like, dude, I'm gonna ride on. I will not be stopping at this place. I was not feeling hungry, man. I was not hungry. I was not tired. I was just enjoying the whole ride. And that's how I sort of ended at Mori Plains. I don't know what happened to my camera at that point, because I couldn't record Mori Plains. But again, Mori Plains was a place to ride at that point of the day.